Fuels are very dry. We've been very lucky that we have caught the majority of fires small. That includes the human cause and the lightning starts. Fire Resources, no matter what agency they work for, have been working really hard this year.
With the yearly monsoon storms that have been rolling through Utah, you've probably heard the thunder and seen the lightning. And those bolts are a concern for fire crews with these storms moving through Saturday.
That's a concern with this storm system that's moving through right now is outflow winds. Any lightning starts we do get will be pushed by those winds.
In California right now, over 1 million acres has burned this year. The majority of those fires caused by lightning strikes. Utah is no stranger either, with the Milford Flat Fire in 2007, the state's largest wildfire in history at over 363,000 acres caused by lightning.
Weather is crucial for us to understand both what's happening today, watching as those changes happen throughout the day, and then predictions coming up.
Specifically, lightning-caused fires pose additional challenges for firefighters.
Location, so a lot of times we'll have lightning-caused fires in very remote areas. They also can smolder for a few days at a time. We may not detect it initially.
And while the rain that comes with the lightning does make a difference,
it's given us a little relief in some of those areas, especially in southern Utah, where we're seeing the record and near-record levels.
Lightning-caused fires are common and dangerous, which is why fire crews say with things this dry, they've been very lucky so far.
And they've done an outstanding job at keeping fires small so they're not spreading and growing to those large incidents.
Even though we have had a lot of precipitation making this vegetation a little bit more moist, it isn't nearly enough to get us out of fire season. We still will have a ways to go. In Salt Lake City, Spencer Joseph, Fox 13 News, Utah.